Very good class. Today, 9th standard, we learn a chapter of moment, that's Adventures of Toto. Okay? The chapter's title is The Adventures of Toto. Got it? So, the interesting chapter and very simple chapter to understand. It's not a complex story. And the type and the writer of this chapter is Ruskin Bond. The Adventures of Toto, writer Ruskin Bond. As the format says, let's share some meanings. the adventures of Toto. Here are the meanings and the portions. Got it? Now each and every day I will not elaborate these meanings. Make sure that you get it on time. Now let's start the lecture. Start the session. The grandfather bought Toto from a Tonga driver for some of 5 rupees. The Tonga driver used to keep the little red monkey tied to a feeding tube, and monkey had looked so out of place that the grandfather decided he would pet the little fellow to his private zoo. So grandfather has a private zoo, and he decided that Toto, he decided to take Toto. He was hasn't or locked with this Tonga driver. Toto was a pretty monkey. His pride was partnered with mischief beneath deep set eyebrows and his teeth, which were a pearly white. We were over displayed in a smile with fright and with the ladies. But his hands looked dried up as though they had been picked up in the sun of many years. See, here the Toto has been described. Suppose they, if they may ask the question, describe Toto. So, as a monkey, you will describe with the getup, appearance also, how his eyes looks, how his hands was there. So you have to mention him properly. Yet his fingers were quick and wind and his tail, while adding to his good looks, also served as a third hand. He who could use his hand from a branch and was capable of scooping up and delicacy, that may be out of reach and his hands. Okay, grandfather means me always first when grandfather brought some new bird or animal. So it was decided that Toto's presence should be kept a secret from her until she was a particularly good mood. Okay, means you know what? First means literally has been that grandfather has a private zoo, and grandmother at some point she likes and at some point she does not likes the appearance of the animals and birds. Then also grandfather shows her grandmother, grandmother shows grandmother that she, I have brought this animal, she, I have this bird. So, but here, the introduction of Toto was kept secret, the appearance of Toto was kept secret, because when she'll get in a, good mood, then they will discuss the presence. Grandfather and I put him away in the little closet, opening in bed and wall, where he was tied securely or so, thought to peg fastened into the wall. Means he was, when she brought the monkey, he, placed him in a cupboard, put him in a cupboard and tied him so that no one can get around him and no one get, aware of presence of any kind of monkey in the cupboard. Few hours later, when grandfather and I came back to release Toto, we found that the walls, which had been covered with some ornamental paper chosen by grandmother, now stood out as naked brick and plaster. The peg in the wall had been wrenched from its socket, and my school blazer, which had been hanging there, was on its shelves. Yes. Now the disaster occurs. The monkey, which was Toto, he was stood in a cupboard. There he makes a lots of mischief. First, he teared up the wall, not wall, that it was ornamental paper. There was an ornamental paper on the wall. He tore up stick out of the wall. Second, the school blazer of this kid was tore down in pieces, shattered in pieces, and the peg, it was, it's like this. As you can see, it's a peg only. Here it is fastened with animals. Means like this, with this, it's a peg. Here is a penetration area which is deep in the ground. Got it? So it is pegged. So he also the monkey removed the peg, tore down the ornamental paper, and shredded the school peg. So here the mischief of Toto begins, and our story also begins. Proper. Okay, I wondered what grandmother would say, but grandmother didn't worry. He seemed to please in Toto's performance. He's clever, said grandmother. Given time, I'm sure he could have tied the top piece of your blazer into a rope and he made his escape from the window. Got it? So when grandmother observes the scene, she says that he is intelligent because with the help of his shredded portion, he'll make a rope and he'll try to move out of the window, escape from his home, escape from the window. So that scene was for her was a different kind of moment. So she observed him in her own perspective that monkey literally has destroyed school blazer wall and pen, but she realized, she sees that monkey is its nature, it's her his nature. So he is doing his nature only, he is doing his activity by his nature only. But at some points she also said that he is intelligent because with the help of shredded she will try to escape. You know, his presence in the house still a secret. Toto was now transferred to a big cage in the servant's quarter where a number of grandfather's pet lived very socially together. A tortoise, a pair of rabbits, a tame squirrel, and for a while my pet cot. But the monkey wouldn't allow any of the companions to sleep at night. So grandfather would have to leave Dehradun next day to collect his pension in Saharanpur, decided to take him alone. See, here the monkey, you know, he starts his mischief and he was, you know, caged in a zoo where lots of animals were there, but like tortoise, pet, god, squirrel, rabbits. But he did not allow anyone to sleep. Unfortunately, I could not accompany grandfather on the trip, but he told me afterwards a big black canvas kit bag has now opened. When the bag was closed, there was no escape. Toto could not get his hand through his opening and the canvas was too strong for him to bite his way through. His effort to get out only had the effect of making the bag roll out on the floor or occasionally jump into the air. See, now his grandfather moves to the Saharanpur, not moves to Saharanpur, goes to the Saharanpur to collect his pension. So as he was worried for other animals, so he decided to take Toto with him also. Okay, so he got a luggage, that is canvas luggage. It was very strong, and he kept Toto for a while, and it was so strong, too much strong that the Toto can't get escaped. Got it? He can't get escaped from there. If he will try, two situations will occur. First, the bag will roll automatically. Second, the bag will jump from the portion. So only there are two chances. Okay? Toto remained in the bag as far as Saharanpur, but while grandfather was producing his ticket at the railway turnstile, Toto suddenly pulled his head out of the bag and gave the ticket collector in a wide way. Now suddenly at the station when he was showing his ticket, grandfather was showing ticket at the turnstile, suddenly his Toto also appeared, you know, he took out his hand and he also done the same activity, same effort. The poor man was taken aback, but that great presence of mind and much of manners annoyed him. He said, "Sir, you have a dog with you. You'll have to pay for it accordingly." In vain did grandfather take Toto out of the bag and then he tried to prove that the monkey did not qualify as a dog or even as a quadrup. Toto was classified as a dog by ticket collector, and 3 rupees was the sum handed over his fare. Now, he had, you know, at first when he took out his hand from the bag, at first he was a ticket collector, at first didn't recognize, but then he classified him as a dog. Okay, you have a dog, you have to pay for it. So grandfather took out monkey from his bag and showed that, "Look at this monkey, you idiot. It has a tail and it looks like a dog. Do you think it's a dog?" But then also, it was classified as a dog only. How this ticket collector becomes a ticket collector? Even a 10-star student knows that a monkey and a dog are two different kinds of animals. Here also the situation gets worse and he has to pay the amount. The grandfather just took his own bag from his pocket of his pet tortoise and said, "What must I pay for this since you charge for the animals?" Now, here he took a tortoise from his pocket and said, "See, I have animals also. I have more than a monkey, or if, according to you, it's a dog, I'm more than a dog. What do you pay for this? The ticket collection room to close the door and accorded it with his forefinger, gave it for the place and treatment, so no charge, it's not a dog. Okay, so here, the tortoise, yes, when he, you know, he showed the tortoise, the ticket collector was observing very, you know, formally, and he then said, no, it's not a dog, you are not allowed to pay anything. You don't have to pay anything, because it was not a dog. So, when Toto was finally accepted by grandfather, he was given a comfortable home in the stable, where he had for a companion and family donkey Nana. On Toto's first night in the stable, grandfather picked him a visit to see if he is comfortable. To his surprise, he found Nana without claws pulling at her halter and trying to keep her head as far as possible from the bundle of hay. Now, here, he was given a comfortable home in the stable. At first, Toto was in the cage, and then he was in the stable with a Nana, it's a donkey. Now, when at night he came a visit, came for a visit, Nana, that grandfather came to visit whether the monkey and Nana are doing well or not. So, he observed that Nana is facing a terrible problem with his head, and she was lying on the ground. Let's check out. Grandfather gave a Nana's leg across the ranches and she jumped back, dragging Toto with her. He had fastened onto her long ears with a sharp little tail. Toto and Nana never become friends. They both fought very well. Okay? One of the ear was jumped by another person and they both become never friends. A large great treat for Toto during cold winter evenings was the large bowl of warm water given him by grandmother for his bath. He would cunningly test the temperature with his hand and then gradually step to the bath. Now, the last para says about how the Toto takes a bath. How the Toto takes a bath. He observed other persons to how they used to take bath. So, the first test was checking the water whether it's hot or cold, then slightly pouring your leg in the portion and then second portion, then like this. So, it was the gesture, and you know, once comfortable, he would take the soap and his hands or feet and rub himself all over. When the water became cold, he would get rough and rough quickly. Just a second. Once comfortable, he would take the soap in his hands or feet and rub himself all over. When the water became cold, he would get out and run as quickly as he could to the kitchen fire in order to get dry himself. Got it? Become cold, he would get out as quickly as the kitchen fire got it. If anyone doubted him during his performance, Toto's feelings would be hurt and he would refuse to go on with his bath. See, here the chapter is, you know, it's about Toto and we discussed a lot of things. That at first Toto was a monkey and the journey begins from the, you know, Tangawala to the private zoo, and he was not doing well with the Nana, and he has done lots of mischief in the Saharanpur also. And here the bathing situation has been mentioned properly, that when this Toto came at a place near the bathing tub, at first he will touch the water to feel it, whether it's hot or cold. After that, he'll, you know, stable his full entire body step by step in the hot water. Suppose if the water is too cold for him, then he'll, after, you know, if he'll take bath after that, he'll directly go to the kitchen for fire, so that he can warm himself. Okay, as this gesture was not appropriated, because in kitchen, if you get fire, you will lose your jeevan. And if the water is too cold, then you will take bath. After that, you should rub your body and you should stay in a warm place. Okay? So, but he didn't know about this. So, one day Toto nearly succeeded in the boiling himself alive.
Yes.
I told you that one day, all the procedure was going on and on, and suddenly one day he tried to burn him alive. A large kitten cattle had been left on the fire to boil for a tea, and Toto find himself with nothing better to do. Decided to remove that lid, finding the water just warm enough for a bath. He got in with his head sticking out from the open kettle. Okay, this was just fine for a while until the water began to boil. Toto then raised himself a little, but finding it cold outside, sat down again. Let's discuss the portion different manner. That a large kitten kettle had been left on the fire to boil for a tea and Toto. Means there was a large kettle in the kitchen and the Toto was in the kitchen. So it was kept boiled for. Finding himself with nothing better to do, decided to remove the lid. The monkey decided to remove the lid. Finding the water just warm enough for a bath. He find out the water is just enough for a bath. He got in with his head sticking out from the open kettle. This was just fine for a while until the water began to boil. As it was, stove was on, so this portion that becomes heat, more heat. And he didn't realize the hotness, the dangerous scenario. And he tried to, pour that, the stick up the portion. This was just fine for a while until the water began to boil. Toto then raised himself a little, but finding it too cold outside, sat down again. He continued holding and down for some time until grandmother had called him half boiled potato. At first, he was observing that it's cool, but after that, it was boiling and boiling. That it was boiling. So, and suddenly grandmother arrived, and when she realized that this is going getting worse, so she removed the portion of that potato. She threw him out of the kettle. One day, if there is a part of a brain especially devoted to mischief, that part was largely devoted in developing Toto. He was always tearing things to pieces. Whenever one of my aunts came near him, he made every effort to get hold for a dress and tear a hole. Yes, here the narrator of Rasmin Bond says that if there is a portion of mischief in a brain, it is fully developed inside Toto, he mentioned. And one of the incidents he also mentioned that whenever her aunt or her cousin, whenever visit his home, Toto used to tear him in his, the dress, tear the dress and make a hole in that dress. This was the, main portion, main activity of the Toto. To tear all the things. At first we tear the, ornamental paper and shred the school uniform, and here we tear off the aunt's dress. Got it? One day at lunchtime, a large dish of pulao stood in the center of the dining table. We entered the room to find Toto stuffing himself with rice. My grandmother screamed and Toto threw a plate at her. Once one of my aunts rushed forward, received a glass of water in the face. Okay? When grandfather arrived, the Toto picked up the dish of pulao and made his exit through a window. We found him in the branch of that fruit tree. Dish still in his arms, he remained there after eating slowly through the rice, determined to finish it every grain. And then, in order to spite grandmother, who had screamed at him, he threw the fish down from the tree and chattered with the rice very close to 200 pieces. See, here the next situation arises. When the grandmother screamed at Toto, he threw the, first of all, he threw the bottle. At first, actually, he threw the plate. Toto threw a plate at first. Second, he tried to throw glass, but his aunt catch the glass. When the grandfather arrives, and the situation becomes when the grandmother shouts at Toto. So he threw plate, he threw glass, and when grandfather arrives with his plate, he ran toward the jackfruit tree. Okay, on the branch he stood all afternoon. All means entire room only, he stayed there only on the branch, and there he was eating slowly and he was observing the grandfather home. And when grandmother arrived, he threw again the dish on her, and it was, you know, it becomes 100 pieces. So you can, you know, here you can observe that, you know, having a pet like Toto is a nightmare in a daytime. Got it? So while purchasing a pet, you should understand the characteristics of the pet, and you should know each and every basic stuff of a pet. Otherwise, you will have to face this kind of incidents in your daily life. Obviously, Toto was not the sort of pet he would keep for long. Even grandfather realized that we were not well to do and could not afford a frequent loss of dish, clothes, curtains, and wallpaper. So, grandfather found the Tonga driver sort of a bed going only for 3 weeks. At first, see, now grandfather realized that this kind of pet are not allowed as a domestic animals. They are not to be considered as a domestic. They are wild. They are wilderness. They are far more than a wild. An animal like this in our house will make hell out of our house. So he find out the Tonga driver, and there he sell this monkey for, you know, 10 rupees. No, not for 10, 3 rupees. At first he purchased 5 rupees, and then he, you know, sell for 10 rupees. Here the Toto chapter was very simple, and it was over in the first part. In the next part, we are going to take the grammar section of this portion. As I know that here I have the meaning, and also know that you know the meaning of this portion. Then also, first of all, let's summarize the chapter and then come to the meaning. Toto, 5 rupees purchased from Tonga driver, visiting the pet private zoo of grandfather. There he do lots of mischief, not allowed to sleep anyone. Then he goes to the Saharanpur with his grandfather, who was taking her pens, who was taking his pension. There he was classified as a dog, and because of him, there he did not do any kind of mischief, but he was classified as a dog. And after that, when he moved again with his location, returned to his location, he was given a better place to stay, that was a stable. But in the stable there was a donkey, and donkey acted as Nana, and dog, this not dog, Toto and Nana never become friend. They were fighting and fighting. Now Toto, when he was arrived at his resting home's home, Toto does many more very mischievous activity. Like, he told down the ornamental paper. He also tore down the, you know, peg. I have drawn here peg, and you know, shredded the school uniform. So these were the activities done as a in the school, in the cupboard, not school, in the cupboard. Now, when you know, when someone auntie comes, he used to tear up the dress and make a hole in that dress. So here the chapter over, and after that, the grandfather sold him to that Tonga for 3 rupees. And here our chapter of the adventures of Toto is over, and here are the meanings. In the next chapter, we are going to take some of the summary and the grammar section also. Okay, till then, prepare the entire chapter as you can and ASAP, as soon as possible, so you'll get the grammar section. Thank you very much.